fireworks celebrate the new year, but for Republicans, November could mark a new beginning. The reason? Well, they have a chance to win control of the Senate and rule Capitol Hill. The GOP see Obamacare as their ace in the hole. And the chairman of the Republican National Committee tells CBN News they will use it every chance they get.
Politically, the answer is let Obamacare go through. We'll tattoo it to their foreheads and beat them in 2014. The problem with the political answer is that it's a painful thing for a lot of people.
That pain can be felt across the country. In Cooperstown, North Dakota, Brooke Fredrickson found out she couldn't keep her health care plan, even though the president said she could.
It was a lie. It was a lie. There's millions of Americans all over the country. Just turn on the news. You know, it's really sad.
And it's costing President Obama at the wrong time. His approval numbers are down to 43%. That's even lower than George W. Bush, who sat at 47% after 5 years of his presidency. And it could drop even further if the president and Democrats don't quickly resolve Obamacare issues. Republicans need 6 seats to control the Senate, and they're going to go after moderate Democrats who supported Obamacare.
I think it's a political liability for any Democrat who voted for it. Most Senate Democrats, it passed it was one vote margin, so every single one of them who voted for it cast the deciding vote.
Ads are already in full swing.
Mary Landrieu cast the deciding vote for Obamacare.
If I had to vote for the bill again, I would vote for it tomorrow.
And the strategy for vulnerable Democrats? Keep your distance from the president.
Senator Landrieu says President Obama needs to stick to his word.
But Senate Democrats will not be the only ones fighting for their political survival. On the Republican side, some longtime GOP establishment senators are going to get challenges from Tea Party-backed candidates. It's already happening at the top, where Tea Party conservative Matt Bevin is going after Senate leader Mitch McConnell. Others, like Lindsey Graham and John Cornyn, face primary fights as well. This also marks the other political theme of 2014, the Tea Party versus the establishment. The Tea Party wants strong constitutional conservatives in office. The old guard wants to grow their numbers, even if candidates don't toe the conservative line. This debate played out in 2012 after some Tea Party primary winners faltered. And then they received the blame for costing Republicans control of the Senate.
We let races slip out of our hands, and we really let the Senate majority slip away from us over these last two cycles. That's something that all of us ought to agree is something we should never allow to happen.
But that won't be easy. Special interest groups from both sides of the spectrum are already arming for the fight. Senator John McCain tells CBN News all this bickering has to stop.
We've all got to work together, hash out our differences. But our adversary is the Democrat Party, not the Republican Party. Let the Republican primary voters decide who our candidates are going to be, rather than pouring money in attack ads against Republicans raised from Republicans. That doesn't make any sense.
That leaves Senate control in doubt. While in the House, Republicans should still be in charge after the midterm elections. That doesn't mean, however, it's going to be an easy road for Speaker John Boehner. He faces a determined Tea Party caucus and outside groups like Club for Growth and Heritage Action.
I think they're pushing our members in places where they don't want to be. And frankly, I just think that they've lost all credibility.
Talk radio host Mark Levin believes a fight over the true meaning of conservatism is at hand.
They need to embrace and reacquaint themselves with conservative principles, constitutional republicanism, and make the case over and over and over again, and at every angle, fight for it, at every turn, fight for it.
So 2014 begins with a fireworks show that will only get hotter as the elections get closer. David Brody, CBN News, Washington.